1-866-9452 and 1-866-6775.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Radio Show, only on Financial News and Talk. Now live in studio, your host, local and national real estate expert and consumer advocate, Ron Siegel.
And hello again. Welcome to Ron Siegel Radio. This is the show with no real boundaries as we discuss current events, financial markets, politics, sports, even poking fun at the rest of the media. This is the show that connects the dots of confusion delivered by conflicting media reports. We connect the dots so you know the actions you can take, how your family or business can benefit from current events. Most of all, thank you for joining me. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That is my message, and I will be delivering it every day. We're a very focused show. We only chat about items that affect the roof over your head, your bank account, and anything I feel would benefit you. But before we get into our intriguing content today, please join me in welcoming our featured guest, repeat offender, and in the house live and in person, not even Memorex. Agent B is in the house. Brian Bartholomew, welcome.
Thank you. If I keep coming back this many times, you have to start charging me rent, I think.
Absolutely. Hey, let me remind you, if you ever have any more finance-related questions, I am the consumer advocate looking out for you. And you can reach out to me directly, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Just remember, that's the number you call anytime for assistance. When you call that number, it comes directly to me first. There are no operators standing by. I am it.
Quiet, numbskulls. I'm broadcasting.
While I do have a great team when it comes to developing a financing plan or plan to save you money, I personally work with you. Even if you don't have any needs today, save this number in your phone for future reference, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. And, of course, we are celebrating today. We celebrate every day on Ron Siegel Radio, Cinco de Mayo. Now, you know, when they come up with these celebrations of the day, and I get a list of them from our crack staff every day, Cinco de Mayo is also National Hoagie Day. Really?
What's the big idea?
How do you have Hoagie Day on Cinco de Mayo? How does that work? I can understand totally Chipotle Day. That makes sense. Silence the Shame Day. Not in today's environment. Bike to School Day. We don't even go to school in America, so why would we bike to school? That's an interesting issue, easy for me to say. Skilled Trades Day. Interpreter. Damn, they put them in front of me. I can't even read them. Interpreter Appreciation Day. Can somebody help me with English, please? I might need a little bit of help. Let's get on to the markets. Maybe I can understand those. Dow Jones Industrial Average now up 150 points. S&P 500 up 22. NASDAQ up 86. And oil continues its rise today. It's up 23 cents a barrel. Do you want me to make you ill? It's being a Cinco de Mayo. Have you had your tequila yet today? If you haven't had tequila, you may not want to listen to this part, but we're looking at it anyway. So if you want to buy gasoline, not a problem. $2.58. Not in Calizuela. But you might be able to pay $3.80 a gallon. Not in Calizuela. That would be in Hawaii. Calizuela, we're paying $4.06 a gallon of gasoline. That's the average price for a gallon of regular gasoline. Elections have consequences. A year ago, $2.74. $2.74 was the cost of a gallon of gasoline right here in Calizuela. Even then, it was about a dollar a gallon above the national average. Today, the national average for a gallon of gasoline, $2.93. Now, if it was a little later in the day, I'd probably be able to do the math on that and tell you that's about $1.08 national average less than it is in Calizuela. $1.08 we get to pay because we like high taxes, we like high regulation, we like all that good stuff here in the formerly Golden State. Let's move right along and see what else is going on in the world. We'll get into the jobs report in the mortgage minute a little bit later on, but for some reason, people aren't catching a clue right now, especially in the District of Clowns. I mean, District of Columbia, where they don't understand the fact that if you look at some raw data, Height of the pandemic, we lost about 20 million jobs. We've gained, recovered about 12 million jobs. Okay, quick math. That means there's about 8 million still unemployed from the pandemic, those pre-pandemic numbers. Did you look at what the JOLTS report said? That's the job openings report. 7.5 million jobs are available. So there's 7.5 million jobs available, 8 million that has not come back to work. Sounds about even there, doesn't it? Well, if you can get $18 an hour, that's about the price that you're going to get for staying home. $18 an hour, not to work. Now, do you think you're going to go back to work for minimum wage? Right? So who's the competition for employment right now? Yeah, pretty simple. The competition for employment is unemployment. Now, I'm just throwing that out there. Just do you think that that's going to cause a problem? Can somebody tell them at the District of Clowns that that's what's going on right now? Because they don't understand this stuff. Talking about understanding the stuff, ruling came out this morning. Another one of those rulings that we could have guessed. Facebook's oversight board. I just can't. You can't get past some of these things. Another group of clowns. They uphold the Trump suspension.
Surprise, surprise, surprise.
Yeah, so they're saying that the president is not going to be allowed on Facebook, at least until November. That's from their oversight board. But what's the truth of that? Did the oversight board make that determination? Probably not. Who made the determination? Well, I'm going to tell you, no one else will. You can only hear it on Ron Siegel Radio. Of course, the lame street media, they're not going to tell you this for sure. Black Lives Matter, they're the ones that are calling all the shots. Did you even see that this morning? So Gilgar City is up for consideration to be ambassador to India. Okay. I don't know what experience he has to be ambassador to India. He's done such a great job in Los Angeles. But Black Lives Matter says they want to vet him to see what his policies are before they'll approve him or not. Now, why do they get to approve anybody other than the fact that they've got hundreds of millions of dollars in the bank and they're calling all the shots on these different organizations? They are self-proclaimed Marxists. What does a Marxist organization need to do? They need to control what people hear, what people see, what people information people get. Ah, now you're getting the clue as to why they don't want President Trump on Facebook, right? Just throw that out there for you now. President Biden, he may understand this because, oh, wait a second, maybe he won't because he's got a very, very busy schedule. I looked at the schedule for yesterday. Are you ready for this? Get a piece of paper in case you can't keep track of the president's schedule. I want you to understand the president's schedule for yesterday. It is a very, very full day. I know, I'm not sure that I could keep up with him. He's got a lot on the calendar. Ready? 2:30 in the afternoon, he's going to be delivering remarks, or did deliver remarks on COVID. That was it. That was his whole schedule for yesterday. 2:30, delivering remarks on COVID. Somebody else probably wrote those remarks for him, but that was the entire schedule for Cuatro de Mayo. Unbelievable. But you're not going to hear that on the lame media. They don't tell you that kind of stuff. Speaking of lame media, here's another one. May 3rd, Dateline, May 3rd, Associated Press. All right, so where do a lot of, especially small town newspapers, where do they get their information? Associated Press. So did you hear about this one, the shooting of Andrew Brown? Right, so this was a couple weeks ago. Andrew Brown shot by a police officer. Associated Press comes out with their reporting of Andrew Brown. The first paragraph, and I quote, so I want to get it right. Family members have said that Brown was a proud father of seven who was known for entertaining relatives with his stories and jokes, unquote. Yeah, sounds like a nice guy, doesn't it? And what they missed was that the proud father of seven. I'm not exactly sure how he became a father of seven. Yes, I understand biology. Don't go there with me. Right, but I understand that part. But most of the time he was in jail. What was he in jail for, this proud father of seven who has seven kids and known for his jokes and stories? Well, just a little bit of drug dealing here and there, like cocaine, morphine, hydrocodone, heroin. This is that really nice guy, father of seven, who tells jokes. That's according to Associated Press. They did put that in their story further down the line. Talk about burying the headline, right? So what do you think is going to cause? Why do you think that the judge in the case said, we're not going to show the body cam footage of this because there might be some prejudice coming out of that? And now we are seeing that in Minneapolis, the defendant, the police officer, Chauvin, right, they've asked for a mistrial. Apparently, some of the jurors were at protests. Wonder how they missed that one. Moving right along, Dallas-Fort Worth suburb of Southlake. Finally, we've got a news story that I can get behind. Two school board members won, and they came out and condemned critical race theory, the teaching of critical race theory. Finally. Ooh, geez, holy cow. Moving right along, COVID, yeah, it's done. I know there's some places that they've still got it. They got to keep it on. I know India's got a big problem on this, but big battle in New York City and New York State, right? The governor who may have controlled the killings of more people in America than even Dr. Fauci, right? Just my opinions here, guys. Don't get mad at me. I can share my opinions too, right? He says that they're going to reopen the state May 19th. Bill de Blasio, communist, he says July 1st. Who's going to win that battle? Well, now that both of them are battling, that's why I say that the whole pandemic is over. In Calizuela, right, Governor Newsom decided that we can open the state after 1.5 million people were confirmed to have signed his recall petition. Now, you're listening to Ron Siegel Radio discussing your real estate current events and the financial markets. When we come back, we've got a featured home for you brought to you by my favorite lender, .net. Our interest rates expected to rise over the next year. Buying and selling real estate. We're going to talk to the expert in the house on that one. You can reach me anytime. Off-air number, 800-306-1990. 800-306-1990 or ronsiegelradio.com. Facebook.com/ronsiegelradio. No longer on Twitter, but if you miss any part of our broadcast, Ron Siegel 1 on YouTube. Ron Siegel, the number 1 on YouTube. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
Are you tired of paying rent? Are you tired of paying someone else's mortgage? Do you know qualified folks can potentially purchase a $500,000 home for less than $5,000 out of pocket? Ron Siegel can help qualified people purchase their own home at amazing interest rates. If you're tired of paying someone else's mortgage, reach out to Ron today at ronismylender.com. That's ronismylender.com. Licensed under NMLS 217037, Equal Housing Lender.
Blue Water Credit Repair is the industry leader in fixing bad credit. Did you know a 40-point increase in your credit score can save you $40,000 on a home loan and $4,000 on a car loan? You deserve good credit and peace of mind. Take the first step today and go to bluewatercredit.com. and register for a free consultation from one of their credit repair experts. That's bluewatercredit.com.
Are you paying rent because you cannot afford to live in your dream home? Are you paying rent because you don't believe you have the down payment funds to purchase your own home? At Siegel Lending Team at ronismylender.com has up to $25,000 to help qualified people purchase their own home at amazing interest rates. Contact the Siegel Lending Team today at ronismylender.com. Again, ronismylender.com. Licensed under NMLS 217037. ronismylender.com.
Dreaming of your retirement does not include losing your house. However, due to today's lower stock market, higher medical bills, and taxes, many retirees face this very problem. This is why it is necessary that you, as a baby boomer considering retirement within the next 10 years, understand reverse mortgages and what one could do for you or your parents. A reverse mortgage could make it possible for you or your parents to travel, buy a second home, or start a new business. For more information about reverse mortgages, just call our off-air number at 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Or visit realestateradiowithron.com and click the free workshop button.
Do you know a homeowner experiencing divorce? Do you know a real estate reference and the divorce decree could cost tens of thousands of dollars? A certified divorce mortgage planning and real estate report could save you thousands of dollars, and it's free from your local certified divorce lending professional. Reach out to Ron today. RonIsMyLender.com. Again, RonIsMyLender.com. Licensed under NMLS 217037, Equal Housing Lender.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Welcome back to Ron Siegel Radio. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That is my message, and I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio or anytime at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. The Mortgage Minute today being brought to you by our friends at Geneva Financial. When you're ready for that next home loan, Geneva's got the programs and the products. You just need to make the call, 800-306-1990. Kendra's standing by to help you. Just give them a call, 800-306-1990. Happy to put you in touch. Take a look at what the markets are doing today. Dow Jones now up 131 points. NASDAQ up 81 points. S&P 500 up 22 points. 10-year Treasury yield is up one tick. The mortgage-backed securities are down two ticks. Guess that doesn't tell you a whole heck of a lot, right? Because that means they're flat, not doing a whole heck of a lot. But what's important is, why are these things happening? What's going on in the world to cause them? Well, PMI composite final for April increased to 63.5 from March's 59.7, higher than expectation. Services increased to 64.7. That's an interesting note right there. We ISM non-manufacturing index measures the health of service industry came in at 62.7 for the month of April, below the expectations of 64.2. Janet Yellen opened her yap yesterday. Unbelievable on that one. We saw what was going on there. No, stop that, you guys. That's not nice. She's the Secretary of the Treasury. You can't talk about her that way. But she still thinks she may be the chairman of the Federal Reserve, and she's not, right? So she talked about maybe having to increase interest rates. Did you see how the stock market sold off right after she said that? And then did you see her doing her Michael Jackson impersonation, right? She had to backtrack, walking that one back right afterwards that, oh, no, we may not increase interest rates so soon. ADP employment report showed that there were 742,000 jobs created in the month of April, slightly lower than the 800,000 expected. March's report was revised higher by 48,000 from 517 to 565. Leisure and hospitality led the way with 237,000 new jobs in total. The service sector added 636,000 new jobs. Goods producing industries added 106,000 jobs. Manufacturing added 55,000 jobs. Construction added 41,000 jobs. Large companies added 277,000 jobs. Small businesses added 235,000 jobs. Medium businesses added 230,000 jobs. Whew. We're going to get the big report on Friday. Oh, I'm not going to be here, so I won't give you all those numbers. But the Mortgage Bankers Association released their mortgage application data showing overall application volume decreased by 0.9%. Purchases were down 3%, but are up 24% from this time last year. We're going to talk to H&P about that one in a minute. However, that was when things were shut down, up 24% over a shutdown economy. Wonder what that means. Okay, refinance share of mortgage activity increased from 60.6 to 61%. Interest rates are 25 basis points, or roughly a quarter lower than this time last year. They're up a little bit week over week. But remember, you got to pay a little bit to get those rates. People still don't understand that the issue here is interest rates. Yes, they are up a little bit. And I've talked to you about this one before. But up as compared to what? Right? So the Freddie Mac came out with their number, and I'm using a Freddie Mac number for those of you who are compliance folks. Right? Freddie Mac, they said 2.98%. You had to pay 0.7 to get it on the report from April 29th. up from 2.97. Up from 2.97. Now, clue me in here. Isn't that still a good interest rate? We'll talk about it. That's the Mortgage Minute brought to you by our friends at Geneva Financial. So, Agent B, what do you think? You've been doing this for at least 20 minutes, right?
Yeah.
How many years are you into this?
21. Yeah.
21
no,
years.
No, 21 minutes.
Oh, 21 minutes. Okay.
Seven years in.
7 years in. So, yeah. roughly, what were interest rates when you got started?
Oh, they had to be in the fours. And probably the mid fours, almost five. I mean, they were there last April.
I am not going to date myself saying that I bought my first house at 18% interest. Yeah. Right. So being going up all the way to, I'm looking at last year, I'll go to 2017. January 5th, 2017, 4.2% was the Freddie Mac interest rate. And we go to January 7th, 2021, 2.65. So if we go up to 3%, let's not use all those extra pennies after that. Is that okay, right? Just call it 3.
Don't panic, yeah.
Is that still a good rate?
Yeah, I think well, I don't know if you have the numbers for, what was it, February or March of last year? We were like 4.5%.
Right.
You know, so everybody's freaking out at when we're getting up close to 3. It's like, take it easy. It's, you know.
Yeah, I mean, it's all the way up to 3.
Yeah, it's just, right? Yeah, and the difference is, you know, $20 or $30 a month, you're going to be okay.
And you know. So interest rates have gone up just a little bit. Wages, we already talked about in the last few days, have been going up. But the most important number I'm going to submit in any kind of a real estate transaction is interest.
Yeah.
Right? Because that's a big, you look at any kind of, if you're not paying cash, but you look at the interest rate, that's going to be drive your payments more than anything.
Affordability, of course.
There you go, affordability. So the concept here is even if our property value is still increasing,
yeah, those aren't slowing down anytime soon. I don't think so.
Can we call that supply and demand?
Yeah, I mean, and I think up until what, January, February, we had a record number of mortgage applications like every month since April of last year. I mean, more and more people applying for pre-approval letters. I mean, it's been out of control how many buyers there are out there.
A lot of buyers out there. What are you seeing as far as listing? Is there inventory out there to buy property?
I think it went up like, in the last week, it went up like 5 or 6%, but now it's down again like 5 or 6%. So I mean, it's just the inventory is just so tight. It's so hard.
You know? Nothing out there.
But when it comes up, it's gone immediately. If your home is on the market for more than a week, there's something wrong.
You know, I had that conversation with somebody early this morning. They called me, and we're talking about when you got involved in real estate. Was the concept at that point, you know, we'll list it for a dream price and negotiate down? Were you doing it that way?
No, I mean, there were people doing that. But, I mean, when I had listings in that time, you know, it was more like, let's find where the comps aren't listed at the comps. And just, and I mean, but you're doing that now. I mean, we're listing at the comps and we're going 5 to 10% above the comps.
5 or 10.
By the time we're done.
By the time you're done. Okay, that's the part that I wanted to get to is, when you get done, you're above the comps.
Yeah. I mean, we're starting at the comps. And so you just can't believe that when we're listing a house for $800,000 and or $850,000, we're ending at $950,000. You know, it's just incredible.
So there's still not a lot of inventory out there, even though it went up a little bit. Interest rates are still low. I just pulled up a chart and I'll try and share this. But, well, you know, I think I can share it right here, right now, if I can figure out how to get my computer to make funny pictures show up on the screen. If you're watching us on RonSiegelRadio.tv, the social channels, or the ABC News and Talk AM 1490 newsfeed. So you're looking at interest mortgage rates by decade. So in the 2000s, the average rate was 6.29%.
Yeah.
Freddie Mac number, right? 2010s, 4.09. That's when you got involved, got started,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So today, 2.81. I had to be the lucky one to get involved in real estate. 12.70 was the average for the 80s, right? So think about some of these numbers. It's still staggering how inexpensive.
Yeah, I mean, and that's why, I mean, it's almost like demand could go up by another 5 or 10%, and we'd still just have prices going crazy because there's just so many people that see that 2.5%, 3%, 3.5% mortgage, and they're still just trying to get a house right now because it's just cheaper than renting still.
Still, there's the whole thing. And
yeah.
And you look at it, and I don't have the chart in front of me, but I think I said we did this yesterday, that home prices appreciated by like 12% last year, according to CoreLogic or FHFA.
Yeah. I mean, some areas in Orange County are up over 20% in a year. It's incredible.
So think about that. If you bought a house and it's up over 20%, what if you took that money out of that property, refinance, take the money
call
out.
Call Ron Siegel and refinance.
And then buy another piece of property and rent it out.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Right?
Yep. Absolutely.
Can you help someone do that, Brian?
Absolutely. Yeah. And I've got clients doing it. I mean, people that literally bought at the beginning of last year or 2019 that are now like, man, I've got, you know, $100,000 of equity in my house already on top of what my equity was already when I put my down payment in. I'm going to take that out and buy something.
Think about that. Now, don't take that money out. And when he says buy something, he doesn't mean buy a boat. Doesn't mean buy a new car. Doesn't mean go and buy a nice vacation somewhere. Those are depreciating assets, although the vacation isn't even an asset. But those depreciate. The concept, and that's what caused the problems of 2007, 2008. People thought that their house was called ATM. Not ATV, but ATM, right? So you don't do that. Buy another piece of property. Call Brian. Yeah, and see if he can help you buy another piece of property, rent it out, stay on a strong path to financial freedom. That's the idea. You're listening to Ron Siegel Radio, discussing your real estate current events and the financial markets. When we come back, are interest rates expected to rise over the next year? We're going to talk about that. Where is the real estate market going? What do you need to do? How do you get an offer accepted? Maybe we can get some insight into that one, all that and more. And hey, we've got a trivia question. $100, you're going to win $100 on a trivia question. We'll do that. The featured home, we got a lot to do today. I'm tired just thinking about all this. You can reach me anytime. Off air number 800-306-1990. 800-306-1990 or ronsiegelradio.com. Facebook.com/ronsiegelradio. No longer on Twitter, but if you miss any part of our broadcast, shame on you. But the replay is available. Ron Siegel 1 on YouTube. Ron Siegel, the numeral 1 on YouTube. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
Do you know a homeowner experiencing divorce? Do you know a real estate reference and the divorce decree could cost tens of thousands of dollars? A certified divorce mortgage planning and real estate report could save you thousands of dollars, and it's free from your local certified divorce lending professional. Reach out to Ron today. RonIsMyLender.com. Again, RonIsMyLender.com. Licensed under NMLS 217037, Equal Housing Lender.
Are you earning a safe, secure 10%+ return on your investments? Is your credit score over 800? Are you living in the home of your dreams or simply where you think you can afford? If the answer to any of these questions is no, what are you doing about it? Text ATP to 79564. Complete a 3-minute complimentary survey and the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio will reach out to you to develop a success strategy for you. Again, all you need to do is text ATP to 79564.
Are you paying rent because you think you cannot afford to live in your dream home? Are you renting because you don't believe that you have the down payment funds to purchase your own home? The Siegel Lending Team at RonIsMyLender.com has up to $25,000 to help qualified people purchase their own home at amazing interest rates. Contact the Siegel Lending Team today at RonIsMyLender.com. Again, RonIsMyLender.com, licensed under NMLS 217037. RonIsMyLender.com.
Are you currently renting a home? Do you like paying someone else's mortgage payment? Why not explore the options to purchase your own home? Can you imagine a 30-year fixed rate below 3.5% APR? This means with $10,500, you can purchase a $300,000 home and have a principal and interest payment of about $1,300 per month. What are you paying in rent? Does your family deserve the opportunity to take advantage of the current market? To learn more about these exciting opportunities, the Siegel Lending Team is standing by to speak with you. Call now, 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Or visit SiegelLendingTeam.com. That's S-I-E-G-E-L, LendingTeam.com. Rates subject to change without notice. Licensed to NMLS ID 217037, Equal Housing Lender. Not endorsed or sponsored by any government agency.
Are you tired of paying rent? Are you tired of paying someone else's mortgage? Do you know qualified folks can potentially purchase a $500,000 home for less than $5,000 out of pocket? Ron Siegel can help qualified people purchase their own home at amazing interest rates. If you're tired of paying someone else's mortgage, reach out to Ron today at ronismylender.com. That's ronismylender.com. Licensed under NMLS 217037, Equal Housing Lender.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert, Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Welcome back to Ron Siegel Radio. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That is my message, and I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio or anytime at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. The real-time real estate segment today being brought to you by the area-trusted real estate professionals of Ron Siegel Radio. Text SLT Home Digest to 79564. Find your dream home before someone else does. The Digest, compliments of Ron Siegel Radio, tells you exactly what the market believes about your property and what the county recorder knows about your property. It's all right there in the digest. We send you an email once a month giving you all that updated data so that you have all that information right there on hand so you can make an educated decision. I like the idea of making educated decisions. I know some people say that I just bloviate off the top of my head. I get it, but how do you make an educated decision if you're not educated? Our interest rates expected to rise over the next year. So far this year, mortgage rates continue to hover around 3%, encouraging many hopeful home buyers to enter the housing market. However, there's a good chance rates will increase later this year and going into 2022, ultimately making it more expensive to borrow money for a home loan. Here's a look at what several experts have to say. Danielle Hale, Chief Economist, Realtor.com. Quote, our long-term view for mortgage rates in 2021 is higher as the economic outlook strengthens thanks to progress against coronavirus and vaccines, plus a dose of stimulus from the government. This pushes up expectations for economic growth. Lawrence Yoon, Chief Economist, National Association of Realtors. In 2021, I think rates will be similar or modestly higher. Mortgage rates will continue to be historically favorable. Freddie Mac. Quote, we forecast that mortgage rates will continue to rise through the end of next year. We estimate the 30-year fixed mortgage rate will average 3.4% in the fourth quarter 2021, rising to 3.8% in the fourth quarter of 2022. Ow! Below, and I'm going to share with you some of the forecasts from some of the different individuals, and I'm going to get that right there on the screen for you. Yeah, you can see it for yourself. What's some of Freddie Mac, Fannie Mae, Mortgage Bankers Association, National Association of Realtors, and the averages for all of them. So the average forecast here from all of those organizations for by the end of next year, 3.68%. Still a pretty good rate. Bottom line, if you're planning to buy a home, purchase a home before mortgage interest rates may rise and help you significantly over time. That is the real-time real estate segment, again, brought to you by the area-trusted real estate professionals of Ron Siegel Radio. Text SLT Home Digest 79564. Find your dream home before someone else does. Agent B is in the house. We're just chatting real estate, and if you've got any questions or thoughts, you can put them into the comment section. But the fun part of doing what I do is, you know, I just get to throw out questions and put Agent B on the spot here. And usually it works out pretty well because he knows what the heck he's talking about. So chatting real estate, he's told us in the last segment there's a little bit more inventory on the market. A little bit, not a lot. Sold all of it.
Yep, gone.
we just turned into May, which is generally a pretty solid buying time, right? Because people want to get out of their house after the school year is over. We don't have to worry about weather in Southern California. Yeah,
May, June, July is the hottest time of the season. It's going to be that way again, I'm sure.
So here's the concept, and maybe you can help us in economics 101. Right? We don't have much demand, and people are going to start wanting to buy. What's that do to prices?
Going to keep going up, man. we just talked about this. You know, they're going to... We're putting houses on the market at the what we think are the comps, and they're going at 5 or 10% above that when we finally close.
Does it matter? I mean, if they go above the, if they sell it, if you're thinking about buying, if I'm thinking about buying a house either for my family, and I've got a, now I'm old, so this is a little bit different than many cases, but you know, you have young kids, right?
Well, no. 13, 17.
Okay, so I guess so, yeah. So 13 is still going to probably, what do you have, 4 or 5 years until college, right? Yeah. So you've got at least a 5-year horizon in most instances. If you have 5 years that you've got kids in school, you're going to probably be pretty stable in an area for a 5-year window.
At least, yeah.
If I spend 5% too much on my house today, does it matter over a 5-year period?
Probably not. I mean, it's going to, you know, at the end of the day, look at every market we have. You know, there's a graphic for you that are watching. You know, it goes up like this, it goes like this, it goes up like this, goes like this. I mean,
so it goes up, it almost plateaus, but not quite. It's still, yeah, the plateau means it only goes up a little bit instead of a lot.
Hopefully, we learned our lesson in 2008 that we didn't, you know, it's not going to go like this. Well, that's even if it does, it goes like this still.
But that's happened once in 50 years. Yeah. So we're okay there. Yeah, and no, I don't think we're going to do that again.
Yeah, you're buying a house. I just had this conversation with a client this morning where just, you know, they're talking about buying a house where they don't want to overpay, and we just went in escrow. And I was like, look, if you're going to be in there for 10, 15 years, you're buying the house to live in the house.
You right.
Know, we added 400 square feet onto the house, spent a bunch of money in the backyard, put a pool in, did all these things. But, you know, 15, 20 years later, you're getting your money out of it anyways. You know?
With a nice profit, I would think.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
I mean, just think about, and I don't even want to think about it because I know the numbers, right? 20 years ago, whatever house you bought 20 years ago.
Yeah.
Right. It's probably 4X, 5X right now.
Well, at least 3X.
Yeah. Right. So if you spent $200,000, it's a $600,000 house now.
Yeah. We spent mid threes, and it's worth almost $1 million probably. You know, so it's just crazy.
Yeah. So that's the concept there. Now let's flip it to the other side that we started talking about in the last segment. Was, you know, taking money out of a property if you've got some real good appreciation. And I've shared many, many times with 100% certainty, the rate of return, I don't guarantee a whole lot of Ron Siegel Radio, 100% of the time, the rate of return on home equity is zero, right? You get zero rate of return on home equity. If you have a lot of equity in your house, the property value is going to appreciate by whatever it appreciates at. If you have no equity in your house, it's going to appreciate by whatever it appreciates at. Get the equity out. What do we do with that equity?
Buy another property.
Buy a rental, right?
Absolutely.
So think about this. So if I can, I use the term liberate. If I can liberate $200,000 out of my current property, and being that in Orange County, the median home price, last I looked, was $829,000.
Yeah.
So if I can liberate $200,000, can I buy a $600,000 house?
Absolutely. I mean, that's the $200,000 is more than 20% down. You know, you did, but that's your 25% down pretty much, and that's going to cover if you're an investment property, and then your renter is going to pay for that. So, you know, why not have it and hold on to it?
So here's the concept. If I'm renting, I pay someone else's mortgage.
Right.
If I'm the landlord, someone pays my mortgage.
Correct. Plus a little bit extra, I think. So.
And who gets the appreciation?
You're getting it,
right?
Buddy.
Yeah. The landlord gets it. So, right. So even if you had to overpay on an investment property, I mean, I know investors are always saying, well, I can't pay the same as what a consumer pays.
Yeah.
Who has more emotions tied into a piece of property, the investor or the consumer?
The consumer for sure.
Right. They got an emotional buy.
This is like we're talking about the stock market. You got to be in it for the long term.
Right.
If you're looking to turn and burn properties right now, maybe they're not great investments. But if you're looking to, you know, buy and hold, you know, that's a great time to do it. For sure.
I'm not sure there's ever a bad time for a buy and hold.
No.
But especially in real estate. And we haven't even talked about, you know, you brought up the idea of the stock market. For the most part, people that are buying in the stock market, you invest $100, you get $100 worth of stock.
Yeah.
Right? In the housing market, you invest $20, you get $100 worth of house.
Yeah. At the end of the day, yeah, for sure.
Right? So if I've got the same 5% appreciation on my stock market, I gain $5 on my $100,
yeah,
or I gain $5 on my $20.
Correct.
And I'm a simple guy, so I like little small numbers,
right? Yeah, I like it.
Now, just add a few zeros to the end of both
that's
of those.
That's a good ratio.
Right? So where are you going to make more money? Contemplate that part. So even if the housing market doesn't grow as fast as the stock market, but it has been lately, right? You're still better off in the housing market because of leverage. Think about that concept. And then, you know, somebody else makes your mortgage payment. Every mortgage payment gets you more equity, right? Part of it's going to principal. Part of it's going to interest.
Yeah.
Every one of those payments gets a little bit of depreciation, so it helps your tax burden.
And the house value is going up.
And the house value goes up, and you get to keep that.
Yeah.
Does that sound like a win?
Yeah, but plus when that one-year lease or two-year lease is up, chances are you're going to be able to raise
rent.
Even though we have some rent control here in California, you can still raise it up every year. You know, and you'll continue to make more money on it. So,
and I'm going to throw out the concept: what if you don't raise it? Right? There's no rule that says you have to raise it.
Oh, sure.
And if you don't raise it, and you make sure that you're always 100% occupied, right? I mean, I love people that say, "Well, I'm going to raise it 5% every year." Okay, well, what if it's vacant for 1 month?
Yeah.
Right. That just wipe out 20 months worth of raises,
basically.
Right. Yeah. Think about that concept. You're listening to Ron Siegel Radio, discussing your real estate current events and the financial markets. When we come back, more with Agent B and Featured Home, brought to you by my favorite lender, .net, all that and more. You can reach me anytime off air. Number 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com, facebook.com/ronsiegelradio, no longer on Twitter. But if you miss any part of our broadcast, Ron Siegel 1 on YouTube. Ron Siegel, the number 1 on YouTube. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
Are you tired of paying rent? Are you tired of paying someone else's mortgage? Do you know qualified folks can potentially purchase a $500,000 home for less than $5,000 out of pocket? Ron Siegel can help qualified people purchase their own home at amazing interest rates. If you're tired of paying someone else's mortgage, reach out to Ron today at ronismylender.com. That's ronismylender.com. Licensed under NMLS 217037, Equal Housing Lender.
Is your credit score over 800? Are you living in the home of your dreams or simply where you think you can afford? Are you earning a safe, secure 10%+ return on your investments? If the answer to any of these questions is no, what are you doing about it? Text ATP to 79564. Complete a 3-minute complimentary survey, and the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio will reach out to you to develop a success strategy for you. Again, all you need to do is text ATP to 79564.
Do you have a goal of mortgage-free home ownership? What if your home was valued at $500,000? Are you aware that a free and clear home could be costing you $2,500 every month, $30,000 per year? The mortgage planners at the Siegel Lending Team would like to show you how you can own your home, generate tax-free income, and accumulate family wealth. You simply need to call Ron Siegel at 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. By sending the team a copy of your most recent mortgage statement, the team will send you a no-obligation mortgage adoption plan. You be the judge if it's right for your family. Again, all you have to do is send the team a copy of your mortgage statement by email to map@ronsiegelradio.com or call today Ron Siegel, 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Rate subject to change without notice. Licensed by the California Department of Corporation and NMLS 217037 and DCALBRE number 01869452.
Are you paying rent because you cannot afford to live in your dream home? Are you paying rent because you don't believe you have the down payment funds to purchase your own home? At Siegel Lending Team at ronismylender.com has up to $25,000 to help qualified people purchase their own home at amazing interest rates. Contact the Siegel Lending Team today at ronismylender.com. Again, ronismylender.com. Licensed under NMLS 217037. ronismylender.com.
Do you know a homeowner experiencing divorce? Do you know a real estate reference and the divorce decree could cost tens of thousands of dollars? A certified divorce mortgage planning and real estate report could save you thousands of dollars, and it's free from your local certified divorce lending professional. Reach out to Ron today. ronismylender.com. Again, ronismylender.com. Licensed under NMLS 217037, Equal Housing Lender.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert, Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Welcome back to Ron Siegel Radio. This is the show with no real boundaries. As we discuss current events, here we go. We're ready for the final segment of the show today. Time flies and we're having fun.
I'm telling you, man, I've been stretching out the whole time.
I don't even want to go there. There's anything I can say could only get me in trouble. Hey, we got the featured home segment today being brought to you by my favorite lender, .net. Who's got the property? Where is it? Let's see if I can find a home. Should we be able to find a home to feature today? Sometimes it's difficult with the way inventory sells right now. Sometimes it takes us more than 5 minutes to find one. So let's see what we can find. Aha, there it is. I see it coming onto the screen right now. John Perez. He's the man, 4905 St. Andrews Avenue in Buena Park. Three bedrooms, a full bathroom, and a three-quarter bathroom. Single-story ranch-style home in one of the most desirable neighborhoods in Buena Park. Driving up, you're going to find a circular driveway, gated RV parking off to the side of the home. Entering the home, you have a foyer leading to the family and dining room area, which boasts great natural lighting coming from the wall. Okay, a wall of windows and sliding glass door. Family room features a fireplace with a sitting height hearth. Dining area flows nicely into the family room and kitchen area, making this section great for entertaining dinner parties. I love reading some of these things. They're kind of fun. Hey, at $789,000, that is a property in Orange County. So it looks like a single family home, $789,000. Let's look at some financing options for you. 3.5% down FHA. We're looking at 31.12 a month. 20% down, 2704 a month. 25% down using the Ron Siegel Radio strategy, 2416 a month. But think about that one. Three bedrooms, one full and a three-quarter bath, and you're looking at under 2500 a month. That's principal and interest. For those of you keeping score and all those compliance people that are out there, APR is 3.773, APR of 3.178, APR 2.962, and MLS 217037. And oh yeah, you do have to make sure you're adding in the insurance, taxes, if there's any mortgage insurance. But think about some of those numbers. Now I know the FHA, you can't do that if you want a rental. But think about that. If you put down 25% and you're looking at about $2,500 a month plus taxes, insurance, can you rent that three-bedroom house out, a single-family home for that? I don't know. I'm a radio guy. You got to talk to a realtor about that. But that is the featured home today brought to you by my favorite lender, .net. John Perez has a property. If you want more information, give me a call. I'll put you in touch with him. 800-306-1990. 800-306-1990. Agent B is in the house. We're chatting real estate. It's fun that when you have people that know what they're talking about and they come into the broad. Now we don't bring people in here that don't know what they're talking about. But every once in a while, sometimes it's the host that doesn't know what they're talking about. But every once in a while, we do have some concept or plan of what we're going to chat about during a broadcast. When Agent B and I get together, hey, it's just off the cuff, and I don't even have cuffs. So we just go for it and talk about what's going on. So you're in North Orange County.
North Orange County mostly, yeah.
So before the broadcast, you're talking about some people that are actually deciding to leave the formerly Golden State.
Yeah, I had over a dozen families last year, and I've probably had four or five this year, and just – people are, yeah, it's kind of done.
How do I find a great real estate agent in another state if I live here in California?
Yeah, I mean, great question. I mean, after last year with the kind of exodus that I saw with a lot of my clients, I started reaching out to a lot of agents, you know, all over the country through Instagram. And I've got about 650 agents now in my referral network. And I've already closed three deals with those agents throughout the country. And I've got people moving out, you know.
Three families who were able to get find an agent that pretty much
yep.
vetted and carried the agent B seal of approval.
Yeah, and then not just that, but then I follow up, and that agent and I are in contact at least once or twice a week to make sure everything's going okay. And if my client calls me and says, hey, this person's not taking care of me, then I'm on the phone with that agent to make sure they are. So,
so you're still getting agent B service while you're dealing with
100%.
With these other issues.
Yeah.
And as I've shared with you many, many times, $73.52 billion leaves the state of Calizuela every single year in adjusted gross income.
Yeah, I guess they still think something's going great.
So there's the trivia question for today.
Yeah.
Right? Put that in there. Trivia question, rsrtrivia.com, rsrtrivia.com. 73.52 is the answer. And we're going to have a raffle. The beginning of June, $100 Amazon gift card for everybody that puts their name or goes online, rsrtrivia.com. You make sure you put the correct information in there, your phone number and email, because somehow we got to get in touch with you if you win. $73.52 billion in AGI leaving the state.
Yeah, I mean, they're still going.
So. Did any of the clients that you helped go to Nevada, Texas, Arizona, or Oregon?
Texas. I had a few go to Texas, but they're also going into Idaho.
Idaho, okay.
And then Florida and Tennessee. Those are the kind of the four biggest spots.
Okay, well, they aren't on the top four for where the money's walking to, but
definitely Texas.
Yeah, Nevada's number one, Texas number Nevada, $16.95 billion.
Wow.
Left Calizuela in adjusted gross income for Nevada. $12.25 billion left Calizuela for Texas. $10.34 on average leaving Calizuela for Oregon. I don't know why.
Yeah.
$9.63 going to Washington.
Wow.
State of Washington, not District of Clowns.
I think they're trying to stay on the West Coast a little bit. That's what they're trying to do.
That must be it. I mean, that's as much as I could figure out as well.
Yeah.
So they're moving that. Are you having some come the other way around?
Yeah. I have actually, we were talking about this. You know, I have one coming from the East Coast all the way back to the West Coast because she's a stewardess. So I guess she figured she wanted better weather.
Okay.
So instead of living on the East Coast, she'll come out here. It's a little better weather. So. But not a lot coming in, mostly going out. But it's you know, even though it's not great because the money's leaving, it's good because my buyers can now buy houses because these people are vacating.
So it's basically some inventory that's going on the market.
Yeah, a little bit, which is helpful. But
now, how often do you find that you're able to help a family where the property never ever really hits the multiple listing service?
Well, I mean,
have you seen that happen?
Yeah, it happens. I've had a couple of clients. I mean, as soon as we put that coming soon on the, you know, because now the rules, they allow us to do a coming soon for 21 days. So you put that sign out there for 21 days coming soon, I'll probably get a couple dozen phone calls as people driving around seeing it, trying to buy it off market. I've had clients sort of say, yeah, it'd be easier for us. Let's just sell it to those people.
What about inside your office? Do you end up having agent with
Absolutely.
Agent transactions?
Absolutely. Yeah, we'll have agents, yeah, because we'll advertise it in our office first to let people know what's going on, that it's part of the coming soon, and we'll have agents call, too, to try to get in early. It just comes down to the seller, because is it the best thing for them to take a off-market offer, or is it better to go out on the market to get maybe 15, 20 offers, you know?
Depends on what their goals are, right?
Exactly. So, yeah, what's their why for moving? And
I need to get out of town quick.
Then here's your offer and let's go.
Right? Yeah, so
absolutely.
Make it happen, because I've got to try and find a new property, or I already bought something in Texas and now I need to get out of town. If I get my number.
Well, plus, yeah, I get my number. I don't have to fix a bunch of things up. I don't have to stage. I don't have to have tons of people through my house. You know, it's an easy process. Yeah, we do
that. Sounds like that might be a good strategy for somebody that has a need.
Yeah.
And also, just think about that concept when you're thinking about what agent you're going to select. Right. I mean, I'm always there saying, and I don't, you know, I have a real estate license. I'm not qualified to write a contract. Right. That's not what I do. I do a little radio here and there. Right. But the concept is that you got a great agent and you're chatting with other agents all day.
Yeah.
Right. I mean, what else do you have to do?
Yes.
Right. So you're talking to other agents. You might be talking around the water. Are you back in your office yet?
Oh, yeah. We're back in.
So you're talking around the water cooler that 123 Main Street is coming on the market. And my client needs to leave here and they want $750 for it. Who's going to give me $775? Who's going to give me
$800? Yeah. No, I mean, it's one of those things too. I have agents that ask, and we ask the seller, what will you take to put this into escrow tomorrow? And sometimes sellers would be like, this is my number, and put that out to the agents. If someone comes up with it, they got it.
Yeah. And everybody's happy.
Yeah.
Right. And more often than not, I'm guessing if they come up with their number, that's not going to be 10% below market value.
No.
Right. So they've got a number that they may want to list at, and then a number that, hey, this is where I really want to be.
Yeah. Don't be that agent that's trolling me, $100,000 below this price on everything I put on the market. Don't be that guy.
Please. It's not going to get you a property. And even worse than that, if you're in the real estate industry, it's not going to make you a whole lot of friends. Right, because everybody knows where the market values are if they've been in this industry more than at least 10 minutes.
Yeah, for sure.
Great information. If you want to meet Agent B, he's in the house. I can give you his number. Call me at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. And as always, I ask you, set that first radio preset button to come back here and join Ron Siegel Radio, where we only speak about items affecting your house and your bank account. Thanks to all of our sponsors. A big thanks to John and Sean, who are engineering us today. And of course, a special thanks to you for spending a little bit of your day with us. That's all for Ron Siegel Radio. Again, if you have any questions or to meet any of our guests, call me anytime. 800-306-1990. 800-306-1990 or ronsiegelradio.com. And remember, make a lot of money so you can help a lot of people and have a lot of fun. Have a great day. We'll talk to you next time on Ron Siegel Radio.
Call him something, I think I'll just call it a day. Pour me something tall and strong, make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only 12:30, but I don't care. It's 5:00 somewhere.